Hello and welcome, my name is Nilos and this is episode 109 of our Let's Play campaign of Factorio. We have just ruined the base in the last episode by dismantling in our entire train station, and now it's time to rebuild it. Now there are a few things that are in the way. This iron deposit I'm trying to remove as fast as possible, and up here we have our storage facility. There's no point in trying to take out 600 storage chests when I only have two to replace. So I'm gonna need a few more of these cells or train stops or whatever we should call them. Let's build a few more. And I've also spent the time sort of between sessions on just removing a bit more of the wasted area. I do find it quite annoying that there are so many construction robots in the network. I really would like to not have construction robots in the network. You can see there's 43. I wish I could get rid of those, right? They would only come to me. But alas, they don't. That's just the way it is. Now, the next part that I want to complete. Whoa, that's not done. That's not working. Come on, who's doing that? See, that's the reason. That's the reason. Who's taking that one? You are. That one as well. Ugh, I don't like it. Oh, anyway. Now, we have four train stops. Let's move over here and put in more of all of this good stuff. And then we wait for additional come in. And see, again, the issue is that they are producing it. It should be my robots. I do prefer when it's my robots. See, that one got one. Got some. I need to get all of them. Yes, I'm getting a few. I don't only have 17 left. Six more. Two. Good. Zero construction robots left. Excellent. I will be able to put them down here and have them taken away. Now, back to the topic at hand. What I want to do is actually saying everything that comes in, you're gonna go away. Goodbye. Dear train stacker, because I don't want train stackers anymore. They're going to be loading and unloading so fast that I don't need train stackers. That's my theory. And they are going to go in and out so fast that I don't need it. Now, what I do need though is here I'm driving right hand side. So this one is inbound and that's outbound, or it's northbound and southbound. Up on this one, I will only have the ones that are going one direction, which means that I will now officially terminate that. Everyone who comes in here will come from the south. Is that a reasonable assumption? It seems very, very harsh to say everything that comes in must come from the south. But do I have an alternative? I do have an alternative of just bringing it around, but everything must go in here. That's kind of, I want to optimize this. Let's still use this lane here. I'm still gonna have a lot more. So we're still gonna extend it. And at some point I'm going to say, well, this is probably when I branch it in. I'm gonna try it. I have no idea if this is smart or not. It's probably not a good idea to be so exclusive on this. So basically you can go in here because you want to unload, or you can proceed ahead. That is fine. And proceed ahead, that's just taking another round basically. There are no constraints on this, they just need to go in. Yeah, let's build something here. So I get my inbound, and up here I will refresh this one. Again, just completely removing the southbound train. I have no idea how stupid this is, but I'm gonna give it a shot. It's kind of a gamble that I'm putting in, saying you're only coming in from one side. And hopefully that will make sense. Where are you going? Interesting. Why am I actually deleting the power poles? Because the power poles, they are relevant no matter what. There. Okay. Here you go. What is, where's that one heading? That's heading to something that's completely dead. And I'll just remove it as well. Seems very reasonable. That's code one. I mean, I don't really want to delete the old stops, but on the other hand, what's the point of having them? Got it. I do have the issue, for example, with this depot up here, that the only way of getting into that is by come from the south and you're going to go out through the south. That is quite rough. I'll be having this one. This one will then be still the outbound. And I know that it is possible to file all of this, but I'm not too big of a fan of file. Not that it's not working or anything. It's sure it is, but there's just something about putting down the tracks myself. And I do like that. Now, this is also where it gets dicey, because what about this one? This one is not going to go that direction, because from now on, I'm going to delete these and the trains will only go, they're now going on two tracks. Currently, there's one track going, in this case, the upper train is going left or west, and the lower train is going east. That is not the case anymore. From now on, all trains are going, you're dead. Okay, why do we have that? Let's see, you're going to find another path. So in this case, that one to go here, that will never be the case anymore, because I don't want anyone crossing tracks unless they absolutely have to. That one will not function either. Basically, at this point, the only thing you're going to do is you're going to come through from the right hand side, and you will always fork out on the path that you're on. I'm simply going to make, I'm being quite restrictive on what I allow these trains to go. Because I don't mind the trains going a long distance, but I do not want them jamming. It's that simple. It's really that simple. I do not want any trains jamming. Good. That one's red. Obviously it's red. That's perfect. We will here. I'm going to take this one over. I don't think it needs to go all the way, or maybe it does. There and there. Whoops, they are wrong. I need the normal. And I might have some extra ones in the middle. But what I also need is actually the train stops too. Yeah, I know, but you could actually go, couldn't you? No, nothing can go. Don't care. The objective is not for me to fix one little thing. The objective for me is to build a better base. One stupid radar is preventing. Look at this. My glider has drowned. It went into the water and it got stuck. That's one of the disadvantages of having this glider. Ah, okay. So this looks almost full. I'm going to just wreck everything now. So that's six up here. Let's have a look at these below here. They are completely empty at this point. That means I have at least 400 more. Well, I'm going to utilize that to say I'm going to give me at least 600, because I know that anything that can be stored up north can then also be installed, but inserted down here. I am requesting 15 of these, so I should just wait for more to come inbound. I think I have everything I need. Now we just sit back, relax, wait for everything to get pulled in. Have to make sure that I stay within this area. And what else? One stupid radar. Forget about it. Then we're waiting for more. What are we now waiting for? 45. Good. And now I'm going to wreck things really bad. That is what it is. This goes out. This one goes north as well. But it can't, so I need to remove this. Not a big issue though. That should be fine. And I'm really looking forward to seeing how this works. And this is where things get really dicey. Because now I'm going to wreck things. I'm actually going to take... It's going to be fun. There. That's that part taken care of. Whoa, that was a lot of spreading out there. I'm starting with only the most necessary ones. You can see it's already working. It is a lot that needs to be moved. And that's what your robot's for. I do enjoy having robots. I do very much. And compared to the other setup where I do not have robots, then this is just so damn easy. Good, and I'm going to continue this one all the way up there. Huh, I can even pick up more active providers already. Go up and go down. Good, they are now being, of course they're being moved over to those locations, and that's impractical, but it is okay. Maybe get some more. That's not even... There we go. That's one more. But we can see they're working. They are working quite well. There. And that one is now also good. Let's move up here. They are still not good enough. I will draw this line between again. Excellent. This is now almost ready. How much in this one? 10. Seriously? Just give me those 10. Done. And you can now move further. Still not good enough, but at least it's getting somewhere here, right? And what are we doing over here? Again, this is, I think it's the right way of doing it. I don't have any other way of doing it that's less cumbersome. I'm going to remove all of these. They can stick around, but not these. Yep. Not quite. What about here? Almost. I'm still picking up some strange things. Whoops. And again, that one. I guess I am picking up a few of these. Yeah. There we go. Five more. Oh dear. Let's continue on the other side. I know where they're going to be. So one, two, three, and the fourth one. Yep. So let's just continue here and now wait for the robots to do their work. But they do. And what I can do is actually just say the entire path up here will just be littered with those robotized stations. And the issue is that I really should have more stringent ways of doing it, right? I mean, I should be saying, up here we need stone, and I can do that. I truly can, if I need so. There. Should that one also go in the same, I suppose. What I then need to do is actually make there. Oh, for some reason you won't work. This one I can take out because that's not relevant anymore. It's never gonna come back to that location. Do we even have anything in this train? No, not really. So I couldn't take the train down. That cannot be mined is an annoying thing. Yay, raw wood. I love that. Good. That's probably also more than I strictly need. All of this is, the reason why I'm including this in the playthrough is because I think it's important to be able to realize when whatever you've built, however big it is, it just may not cut it anymore. And at that point, there's only one thing, and that's scrap the whole damn thing and start over. At least you're going to be starting at a better position. I don't like this. This is too close. That's fine. I mean, I can... Oops. Good. Now we put in some... 1, 2, 3, 1. Can't figure those out. They're just there for whatever sake. Okay, an excessive amount of signals, but that's not gonna hurt, is it? And now I've turned this one around to become a signal that goes that angle, but that's totally not ready for it. Okay. Next challenge I can see, is it ready for passage? Perfect. And here, also ready for passage. I wonder if this will allow anything to pass through. Now, at least we have the network. You can go in here. You go here. Good. And then I think I just need to continue this path. I'm going to not give any of the robots a break because I want more of this. And I'm going to continue here. Couple more. There. Good. So all of this will now be removed, and that will allow me to build more. You can see all of these are just extremely strained. They're going to be built down here. This is excellent. Wow, just this is the one that it wants to fill up. That's fine. Now, how am I going to do this? I really don't like not having this empty. How big is it? How much time is left on it? It's this one. It's 2 hours. 2 hours? I can't wait 2 hours for this shit here. What I can do though is... Oh, this is cool. I can probably do this. I'm gonna kill that, and that's not gonna be a popular decision. Like this. I'm gonna jam it down. Then we're gonna go up. I'm gonna look again. I'm gonna take that one out. Take that. All of this just goes out, and I don't care too much about what the impact is. If needed, I'll just... Right, so now it's hooked up again. And of course, all of that will just be in shambles. I don't mind that too much. The main problem is I wanna make sure that I move on to the other side of this area. Like this. And moving on. There. Finally. That one works. And now this network is just, it's crashing. Everything is crashing because I've just initiated way, way too much. That's okay. That's kind of the intention of all of this, is to start too much. Also good to know that I am not getting any trains running by and running me over. I think this is a good screenshot of how stupid amounts of active robots I have doing this. I am missing more robot ports. That's actually quite interesting why that happens. I am requesting them, but why are they not coming? It's probably just because the logistics robots are, you know, kind of busy. Good thing that I left one empty. You can take this. How much is missing? Missing one radar. Yeah, I know. Two, four, couple of train stops. That's interesting. And let's move this way. Wow, the robots, they're really slowing down. The UPS is not keeping up, and I need to I think I'm finally in a need to get my get the UPS mod. I don't like it because it's it has this spam of paying the creator money, and I just think that is ridiculous. It is a nice little mod, whatever, but it's not something that needs you begging for money. There are major apps, major mods created, and they are doing it in a way nicer form. So that's just my two cents. Now this looks created, and of course nothing is working because of this shit here, and I am really cautious about whether I want to waste the time on this, because I won't be able to use any of this network until all of this is done. It would be great to see something pass through. Now we can also start seeing, okay, what's the issue here? All of this of course has to go. There. I just keep going until it is completely empty, because I want to extend this line, all of these train stops, and then I'll probably say, okay, the top ones will be stone, these ones will be oil. I'm gonna figure out what oil. I'm gonna have some with iron, I'm gonna have some more with iron, and I'm gonna have some with copper. I'm gonna continue it down south anyway. So I got 50 more, so let's give the robot something to work on while I head down south and build a few more of these stations. Got it. That will enable me to remove the last lines. So now I have 200 left. Ah, oh, look at this junk, robot junk. And of course, there's a few available. That's okay. I'll still continue building. For some reason, they prefer these. And it's because, if I recall correctly, they are selecting them based on their crafting time, or the time that they were crafting, not the crafting time, but the timestamp of their creation. These will be copper deposits or copper loaders. And I want one more. You want one more as well? Yeah, I can do that. And of course, I'm gonna have to fix this up here. If I recall correctly, I will. Oops, good thing it didn't work. What else are we missing? I have that. I have that. I have too many chain circles. Oh, I'm not in a robot network. This is in the robot network, right? Yes, logistics robots are actually done with the work I assigned them to. Fine. Then they are going to get started on the next. I have used so many of those active providers. That's ridiculous. And I'm also going to go over here because I'm having a ton of logistics chest or storage chest that I need to put in. Just want to make sure that I empty this, my inventory. Great. And I'm going to go back here. Put some more things in, like that one. Oh, it's still roboport. That seems strange that I'm missing roboport. 20. I don't have any more logistics chests. They're for some reason not coming in. Let's keep going. And also the train tracks are important. I am just really actively contemplating whether I should have built something else. Whether I should make these into logistics train stops, because then a lot of things will just automatically work. It will. There we go. Roboport going in here, getting charged. Still 176. None of what I'm missing is any problem. I will have everything, but it just needs a bit of time to craft it. So all of this I can delete, because there will be never be trains coming in from this side. Now I would actually say that I have pretty much, created my new train stop. Of course, there's going to be a lot of fine tuning in this, so that's totally to be expected. But it is working, or at least it looks like it's working. This one also needs to be removed. Yes, please. I'm going to actually take both of these in. One, and this one. I think you actually need to go one closer. Oh, that one needs to cut one. One more. There. And there we go. Let's put some friendly things in here. I'm contemplating whether I should allow this one to go on that rather mix and match here. I think that's beneficial. There we go. Now I will have imports from both lanes. Of course, this is not working. They will then go into all of this area. Let's have a look. Still have an issue down here. Not enough storage chests. I actually might be running out of things because it's not the right things I have or that I will take. But this is pretty impressive train. It is definitely scalable, that's for sure. Of course, that doesn't make sense. I'm gonna go through here and move all the way up. And then I'm just gonna split in whatever I want. So I'll have like 10 here called the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 at least called copper. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 iron, maybe like 6, 9. 5 for oil, couple of bricks. I'll take the oil up here as well. I think that's going to be fine. I will leave this as it is, and then we're going to wrap it up. I will just complete this setup, and I'll also work in the meantime on turning everything around so I have two tracks going all the way around. And figuring out how that's going to work. And this one actually needs to go over here so it can go in a circle. Or this one, it actually has to come through here. Perfect. I'm going to do that in the meantime. So I'll see you in the next episode where we start sending some trains through the network. All right. Thank you for joining. See you next time. Bye.